Welcome to today's episode of What Does the Law Say with Arike. Before we move on, please like, share, subscribe, and drop your comments and your questions in the comment section below. Thank you. So in today's episode, we will discuss about the social media bill that everybody is talking about. So in case you don't know, there is a proposed social media act, and the title of the bill itself is not social media bill. We'll get to know what the title is, but everybody knows that social media bill, and you know, Nigerians are saying no to social media bill. So we're going to look at what exactly is the social media bill about, and you know, why people say no to it, and what does it exactly contain, what is it going to restrict us from. You know, everybody says, oh, if the social media bill happens, we're not able to use our internet, we're not able to use Instagram, we're not able to use Facebook and the rest. We are going to look at it. Remember, this is what does the law say, and so we're going to look at what the law says. What exactly is the name of the bill? The bill is Protection from Internet Falsehood and Manipulation Bill. That's the title of the bill, Protection from Internet Falsehood and Manipulation Bill. So funny enough, this bill has been somewhat in existence for about a few years now, but in different names. So we've had the Frivolous Protection Bill, we've had Digital Rights Bill, different bills all trying to still say that they want to curb fake news, they want to curb hate speech, you know, in different ways. Some of them have been rejected based on different contents of the bill. I remember there was one that had a punishment of a death by hanging because of hate speech, and that was rejected. So even this Protection from Internet Falsehood and Manipulation Bill is not so recent. At least it has passed the second reading stage, and now it has all of a sudden come back again, and everybody's talking about it because the government still wants to pass this bill into law. The bill is divided into five parts. So I'm going to list out to you what the parts of the bill are. So the first part of the bill is the aims and the objectives of the bill. So part two of the bill is the prohibition of transmission of false declaration of fact. So that would mean that how can we prohibit false statements, false declaration of fact? Part three is the regulation dealing with the transmission of false declaration of fact. Part four is the regulation for internet intermediaries and providers of mass media services. And part five is the declaration of online locations. So you're probably wondering, what is in all these parts that we mentioned? So we're going to highlight, you know, key points that are there and why we think the bill should not be passed into law. Right into it. The first part, what is even the aim of this bill? I mean, what is the aim of the bill? What is the bill supposed to, if it's passed into law, what is it supposed to achieve? What's the goal of the bill? So the first thing is that to prevent the transmission of false statements. So one of the major aims of the bill is to prevent the transmission of false statements. So it will be seen that the government wants to ensure that false statements are not being passed across or transmitted to different people and everything. So that's the aim, one of the aims of the bill. So secondly, to suppress the financing and promotion of false statements. So in any way which anybody is promoting or financing or bankrolling, you know, any false statement, is to suppress that support. Thirdly, is to enable measures to detect, control, and safeguard coordinated inauthentic online accounts. Lastly, is to enable measures to be taken to enhance disclosure of information concerning paid content directed towards political end. The first part says the prohibition of transmission or false statement of fact, or false statement or declaration of fact. So, I mean, you want to wonder, you want to ask, that if it is a fact, that means it is existing or it is in existence. So there's every possibility that it's true and it is not false. So to me, it sounds like a tautology. So part two of the bill itself, which is the prohibition of transmission of false statements of facts, it says that a person must not do any act in or outside Nigeria to transmit in Nigeria a statement knowing or having reason to believe that. So that's one place that I'm concerned about. You say that a person must not transmit or do any act, if or any statement, knowing or having reason to believe. So if someone is transmitting a fact or transmitting a statement, what if they don't know? What if they do not reasonably believe that this statement they are transmitting is false? So who ascertains it? Who is able to say that, oh, this statement you are making, you should have known that it was false, or you should have had a reason to believe? Who knows? How do you determine whether that statement that person is transmitting is false or not? That's a red flag for me. Okay, so it says that knowing or having reason to believe that it is a false statement of fact, or that the transmission of this statement in Nigeria is likely to be prejudicial either to the security of Nigeria or any part of Nigeria, or is likely to be prejudicial to public health, public safety, or is going to be prejudicial to the friendly relations of Nigeria with other countries, or it would influence the outcome of an election to any office in an election. That is also something that sounds like a red flag. So if someone transmits a statement, a false statement, that they reasonably believe or they know to be a false statement, and it influences the outcome of an election to any office in an election, that person would have committed an offense. So it begs to think that there's going to be public news during election. There's going to be general news flying everywhere during election. Some unverified, some verified. But I think putting this clause in this bill in a way would create that part where there will be opposition, where there will be back and forth. So there's a ruling party in power. The opposing party probably gives a statement, whether they know it's false or not, but they give a statement. The ruling party can come and say that, oh, this statement you made is false, and therefore it has influenced the outcome of the election. In a way, you're creating room for rift, for conflict between the ruling party and the opposing party. It says also that if that person does any act and knowing or has reason to believe that it would incite feelings of enmity, hatred directed to a person, or it would diminish public confidence. So if a person does all of this, if the person makes any false statement or does any act within Nigeria and transmits false statements and result does all of this, whether it affects the election, whether it's prejudicial to public safety, whether it's prejudicial to security in Nigeria and the rest, the person will be guilty of an offense and shall be liable on conviction to a fine of, in case if you're an individual, to a fine of 300,000 naira. Or to imprisonment for a term not exceeding 3 years. 3 years for hate, for false statements. You're going to sentence somebody to 3 years for false statements. I mean, or you fine them 300,000. And then if it is not an individual, it is a fine not exceeding 10 million naira. I think that is ridiculous. Now, the burden of proof lies on who? So when there is falsehood, false statement, or manipulation, or a malicious statement, on who has the burden of proof? Who is supposed to prove that such statement was false or such statement was malicious? So back to this, to the bill. The bill with section 6 says that a claimant, that means whoever is claiming that a statement was falsely made, would be the one to prove that that statement was untrue and that it was maliciously published. So this is another question you want to raise. Already in the laws of the land, you can bring an action for defamation. If somebody should publish any statement that is untrue or makes any defamatory statement or any publication, you can bring an action against that person for defamation. So there is a law that covers this already. There is something that provides for it already. So you want to ask, is there really any need for this social media bill? Moving to the part 3 of this bill. The part 3 of this bill is the regulation dealing with transmission in Nigeria for the false declaration of fact. So the section 6 says that the court of law may order the law enforcement department, that is the police, to issue a patrol regulation. The police can issue a patrol regulation if there is a false declaration of fact and it has been transmitted in Nigeria, or there's an evidence presented to court and it is in public interest to issue the regulation, then a regulation will be issued by the police upon the order of the court. Because that's when our police force now will go and carry work on their head. It's upon the order of the court that they can issue that. So another part of this part three that gets me thinking is the sub three, which says that the court of law may direct the law enforcement department, that is the police, to issue a part three regulation in relation to the subject of declaration of false statement of facts, false statement, even if it has been amended or has ceased to be transmitted in Nigeria. So imagine somebody has transmitted an information and they've ceased that transmission or amended it. The court will still order that the police can issue a regulation. A correction regulation. If a correction regulation is issued under the part three of this bill, it will mean that you that transmitted the false information or transmitted a false statement of facts would have to publish a correction notice, you know, so that you can correct whatever false statement or false declaration that you have made initially. And you can do this either you publish the correction notice in a specified manner, in a specified newspaper or other printed publication in Nigeria. However, under the same section, it says that any person who transmitted a false declaration of facts in Nigeria may be issued a correction regulation, even if the person does not know or has no reason to believe that the declaration is false. So that would mean that whether or not you know that the information you put out is false, if they issue you a correction regulation, you must issue a correction notice to correct the information that you are not sure whether it's false or not. I think if they want to expressly state that if you make a false statement, there has to be something regulating or something that can determine whether the information is false or not. Because if you say that whether or not the person knows, even if the person does not know, rather that's what he said. He said even if the person does not know or has no reason to believe that the declaration is false, the person must still issue that correction notice. So for example, I issue or I put out a false declaration or a false statement of fact. You issue me a correction regulation to correct that statement I put out. Now, that correction regulation you issued me is for me to issue, is for me to publish a correction notice. And I must publish that correction notice whether or not I know or have any reason to believe that information I initially published though was false. Is it already something wrong somewhere? So what if I believe that information I published is correct? What if I verified it? What if I'm sure? Who determines whether the information I publish is true or not? The government or who I am talking about? You wonder, is this really a social media bill meant to curb fake news and hate speech? Or this is a bill that they want to pass into law where they can restrict people's voice? They can restrict people's expression. People have the right to talk. People have the right to freedom of expression, where they can express themselves. It's a constitutional right. It's a fundamental right. But somebody puts out a news that, in their best knowledge, they verified it. They know it's true. But you issue out the correction regulation. How are you even sure that you are correct on the news being false? Thank you for watching today's episode of What Does the Law Say? So we divided this episode into two parts. So you've watched one today and you watch another one next week. So don't forget to join us same time Thursday by 4 p.m. next week for another interesting, fun and educative episode of What Does the Law Say? What Does the Law Say? I'll tell you next Thursday. Bye.